We've now arrived at Chapter 6, where we'll focus on working with the data we've developed in our piping drawings. This chapter will cover moving, copying, and modifying data to enhance our designs. To begin, open the Project Manager, navigate to your desktop, and locate the exercise files under Chapter 6. Select the file labeled project.xml. Next, let's open our Plant 3D drawings by starting with the file named 06_01_piping. One of the key benefits of Plant 3D is how easily it allows you to reuse previously created design components, saving significant time during the modeling process. If you've already modeled a component once, it's simple to copy it and update the associated tag data. We'll first examine our pump configuration. To start, I'll remove any orphan fasteners to clear the workspace. The next step is to add a new pump 6 feet to the right of the existing one. Switching to the parallel view, you may want to unload some structural steel XREFs if things feel cluttered. Adjust your layers to get a clear view. I'll leave everything visible for now. Now I'll copy the current pump configuration, selecting the pump, valves, and vertical pipe runs. After setting the initial position to zero displacement, I'll move the configuration 6 feet to the right to place the new pump. If any unwanted selections persist, simply reselect and cancel to clear the highlighted items. Next, let's check our pump tags. Currently, we have pumps labeled 601A and 601B, but the copied pump shows a 601B question mark tag. I'll rename it to 601C by accessing the Properties panel and updating the tag data. We'll need to update the valve tags as well. By right-clicking, selecting Assign Tag, and choosing the next available number, I'll update all valves in the new configuration. Don't forget the small drain valve, which can be adjusted similarly. Now, let's reconnect the piping. Select the disconnected pipe and use the Continue Pipe tool to join it to the existing line. Plant 3D automatically places a T-joint to complete the connection. Repeat this process for the remaining disconnected sections. With the additional pump installed, let's adjust the pipe elevation. Some pipes are floating, so we'll lower them to rest on the structural steel. Use the dynamic input feature to select the desired elevation. By identifying the top of the steel as 22 feet 4 inches, I'll adjust the bottom of the pipe to match this height. AutoCAD makes precise placement simple. Select any pipe on the run, ensure dynamic input is active, and set the bottom of the pipe to align with the 22 feet 4 inches elevation. Once the adjustment is made, you'll notice the elbow and vertical run adjust accordingly to fit perfectly on the steel. For additional support, I'll switch to a top view and attach U-clamps to secure the pipe to the structural steel. I'll place one clamp and then add another for extra stability. Before wrapping up, let's clean up the line numbers. Some pipes retain a question mark because they were copied. Select the pipe, right-click, and choose Add to Selection. Assign the correct line number by choosing the connected line's number. This step ensures all components are properly tagged and organized. By following these steps, we've efficiently added a new pump, adjusted pipe elevations, and ensured everything is properly labeled and secured, all while letting Plant 3D handle the intricate connections for us.